Thank you for visiting our channel. Today I came out to review and also unbox the latest Buzztv XPL3000. The one that we have on hand is the Sports Edition Red Carbon Fiber. It has a little slider. Once you take it out, the unit itself sits right on the top. And then when you take that part out too, so the components that are part of this is the Buzz XPL3000 Sports Edition Red Carbon, and also comes with a IR remote. Again, that is uniquely set up for the Buzz app itself. Inside of this box, it also comes with an HDMI cable. Also, it comes with a power adapter, which is 5 volt 2 amps. So the box itself is really nicely designed. You can see that it has a nice looking little design on the top. And then also, to make it look like carbon fiber, but it is plastic, it is shiny. And also, huge lettering with the logo, it says Buzztv. And now when you go to the front part of it, you have nice red color in the bottom. And again, these do come with different colors, but the one we got is a red carbon fiber. And you go on the one side of it, you do have three little indicators. And then on the other side of it, even in the front, you do have a little cut. Now that is for your IR indicator. Going on the right side of it, you have a microSD slot. Now that reads up to 128 GB. Right beside that, you have two USB 2.0 ports. Each one can read up to 2 TB hard drive. And then going on the back part of it is where you're going to see the LAN connection, which is 10/100. Right beside that, you have the AV connection so that we can connect it to the older type of TV. Right beside that, you have the HDMI connection, which is 2.0A. And then right beside that, you do have the power connection, which is 5 volt 2 amps. And then you have a really nice looking antenna, which is a little flat. And when you look really closely to it, you do see the logo for Buzz. On the other side of it, there's nothing. And once you flip it upside down in the bottom, you do have 4 little legs so that way it can stand up. And again, there is a little weight to it, but it has a lot of holes for ventilation. You do have a little sticker for MAC address and also for the serial number. Enough said about it, let's get it connected. So as soon as it comes up, it has a nice looking boot up screen, and then it will take you to the Buzz little icons in the bottom that is rolling. So this is their main screen once you go in. It's very unique, and again, it's very easy the way that it's set up. I've seen some other IPTV boxes that are out there, and they are a little bit complicated, and the way that they have set up, this is very easy to look at. So on the top, you have the Buzz logo. Then on the right side, you do have the time. You have huge icons in the front, which is 5 of them. So it says live, VOD, which is video on demand, apps, all the applications will be in it, market, and also settings. So in the bottom, all of these little part is shortcuts. It's very easy to create or remove. And if you're connected via Wi-Fi or Ethernet, will show up on your left-hand side. And also you have a little brush. So this way, anything that is happening in the background, you can click on it, and it will show you that it's just going to clean it up for you. So this way, your box is going to run a lot faster. That's not the only thing. The power button part of it, when you click on it, it gives you 3 menus. It's a standby, reboot, and power off. Now, power off means it's totally going to shut down, so you do not have to take the power out if you want to go outside of the house. And this way, it will shut down. But in front of the box itself, you will see a red light. That means it's off. Now, using the remote that came with this box, it will turn it on. It will see the boot up screen. All right, enough said about that. If you go under apps, it does come with a lot of apps that are part of it, and we have loaded some there, so that way we can benchmark this. First thing first, let's go into settings. And this is their main settings, the way that they have set it up. So you do have server, Wi-Fi, LAN, and then date and time if you ever need set that up too. And also you have display, language, update if you want to find out if you do have up-to-date software or not, or you want to update it. This is a good place to go in order to check that. If you go under more, is where you're going to see the settings. Since this software is 7.1.2, so we will get out of this too. The first thing we want to do with this is going to be some benchmarking. Now we have try to install the Antutu, but with the software limitation, and it is not compatible. But Geekbench, we are able to perform. You can see that it does say Buzz XPL3000. Now, if we go under history, you're going to see that under single core, we got 642, and for multi-core, we got 1835. It's a really good number for S905X chipset. All right, so we will get out of this too. The next thing we have done is speed test. Now, under LAN connection, because it is 10/100, download rate was only 33 to 36.97, the upload rate was only 955, and for the first time we got 7.48. again, this is LAN connection. And then when we went to the single band Wi-Fi, which is 2.4 gigahertz, we got 4173 for first time and 1252 for the upload rate. Once we went to the second time, we got 40.24 for download and 12.63 for upload. But once we changed it to 5G network, we got 138.48 for the download and 8.22 for upload. Once we did it again, we got 144.86 and 10.99 for the upload. Again, they have done their homework, so it looks like on the 5G, you do get over 100 megabits, which we always expect from all the other Android boxes to do the same thing. And same with the download rate for single band and for the LAN. Since this is 10100 LAN, we do expect it to be under 100. Again, it's a little bit lower than the 2.4, but it does the job for us perfectly if you want to watch live TV on this. We will get out of that too. The next thing we want to go through is going to be YouTube. Now, the YouTube app on this is 2.0, and you can see that there's a little bit of a different setup. So we will just search for a 4K video, and let's just play the nature. So there you go, this is one of the videos, and we will go under more options and we will go under quality. And now you can see that it does play it on 4K video. This is what we wanted to see. So the YouTube app on this box, you're able to get 4K out of it. So this is, again, it's really good, and we will just leave it as that and we will get out of YouTube app. All right, so the next thing we want to go through is going to be DRM. Now on the DRM check, you can see that it does have the HDCP level supported, but again, it's just 1.x. That will tell you that your Netflix on this will not be HD. Again, a standard definition. All right, so we will get out of this too. The next thing is going to be the root checker. Now, root checker is a really good thing to have. Let's go and click on verify. So yes, you have full root access on this box. We will get out of that too. All right, so the big moment, which we are going to cover, is going to be live content. In order to set this up, you need to go under settings and under server. Now, once you launch it first time, I have to let you know that you have up to 10 servers that you can set up on this, and it's very easy. So if you are not going to use just Stalker, this will work with Telebreeze and some other ones that are out there. So supposedly it works with 6 different type of platforms. So you can see that the MAC address is really written big, except that there is a way that you can, when you put your URL and you want to change the server name to something different, you do have a username and password that you can put in. So this way it will get you the picture. All right, so let's go and try to do that. All right, so we will just blur out the URL that we are testing today, and we will just click on connect. So it will take a couple of seconds for it to go through, and then it says loading. And I have to let you know that you do have certain shortcuts right on your remote for something like EPG. But if you don't see it, since you are using a Air Mouse remote, you're going to press the menu key. You're going to get this menu on the side. And again, I'm not going to show you the video on the side for copyrighted purposes, but I'm going to let you know that under Live, you also have VOD. EPG is the one that we really like. And again, it does have a needle and it will show you what's playing at one time. And that's going to help you with your PVR. Yes, this box, you can record. So for that, once you are in a channel, and when you